at an open course for the virgin sea. 'Cause I've got to be free. Free to face a life that's ahead of me. On board, I'm the captain. So climb aboard. We'll search.
Go.
On every shore, and I'll try. Oh Lord, I'll try.
140.
Yeah, you're right. Right here, it's 20, 40, 60, 80.
The independent variable for performance of ball bouncing on tile was seconds, and the dependent variable is the cumulative bounces.
So far, I've been graphing my data for the performance of the ball on the tile, and it's been all linear.
So we found the slope of the tile surface was 3, which means that it would be 3 bounces per second.
So we found that the slope of the tile surface is 1.3, and that means that we had 1.3 bounces per second.
Of the concrete surface is 1.7, which means that it's 1.7 bounces per second. Data shows that the carpet was the fastest bouncing surface, and we got 2 bounces per second.
So we originally thought that the tile was going to be the fastest, but we started out first with the tile and moved on to the carpet, and we noticed that as Grayson kept bouncing, she got progressively better, making our prediction
know that the y-intercept should all be 0, 0, but because it's a turned line, it wasn't perfect, but we know that they should all be 0.
A tile was our fastest bouncing surface because at 3 bounces per second, because it doesn't absorb the energy.